very scary people have been taken off the street and brought to our rehabilitation center. And when I say 8 very scary people, what I mean is
one of the 8 people behind me really is Canada's worst driver.
Tab, and I've been nominated as Canada's worst driver by my boyfriend, Matt.
In downtown Calgary, Tab might be the most nervous person on the road.
See, I don't know. I need a call.
My name is Afia, and I've been nominated by my friend Cindy as Canada's worst driver.
In Montreal, Afia might be the most careless driver on the road.
Oh my God.
My name is Ben, and I was nominated by my wife Jan as Canada's worst driver.
In Surrey, BC, Ben might be the biggest daydreamer on the road.
Everybody's wondering who that guy is. It's this guy.
My name is John. I've been nominated by my girlfriend Elise as Canada's worst driver.
In Bowmanville, Ontario.
I know it's going to sound dumb.
Corvette owner John delusionally believes the key to safe texting and driving
is to check up like every 3 seconds. You're good.
My name is Sly, and I've been nominated by my brother-in-law Fred as Canada's worst driver.
In Lethbridge, Alberta, delivery man Sly,
order's been picked up,
got 3 tickets this month for speeding
in a 30 zone,
in a 30 zone,
in a 30 zone.
So that sounds like a school zone?
Yeah.
My name is Lori, and I've been nominated by Sean, my boyfriend, as Canada's worst driver.
In Prince Albert, Saskatchewan, Lori likes to drive with a loose bird, a loose cat, and 2 unrestrained dogs.
I couldn't even tell you how many objects I've hit.
My name is Shirley, and I've been nominated by my daughter Janice as Canada's worst driver.
On the highways of Nova Scotia,
why are you slowing down?
Shirley has a tendency to stop.
Don't stop, you don't stop, you don't stop.
My name is Aaron, and I've been nominated by my father, Lee, as Canada's worst driver.
Aaron was a good driver 6 years ago, but a distracted driver T-boned Aaron. After 2 months in a coma and 6 years of recovery, Aaron is driving around Calgary again, although very badly.
Wait, is that your turn?
Oh.
As a driver, if you don't know where your wheels are, you could wind up anywhere. So, the next challenge for Canada's worst drivers is to show us they know where their wheels are by maneuvering a car across those 2 rails. But first, they have to decide if they want to go backwards, which frankly is kind of scary, or if they want to go forwards, which, let's face it, is a lot easier than going backwards.
To encourage them to go backwards, the rear wheels are already on the rails.
Well, the car's lined up to go backwards, so,
I'm gonna go backwards. Reversing on this course is easy, because
Mirrors?
The mirrors show me the rear wheels and the rails.
And that's perfect.
Will Canada's worst drivers take advantage of our perfect setup? Analytical Sly makes the right decision. But he's going backwards.
Man, I can't believe I'm doing this.
Without using his mirrors. Sly hasn't failed yet. Drivers will only fail this challenge if they manage to get stuck permanently.
Yeah, you're gonna try it backwards again, or are you gonna line up frontwards this time?
Oh, what the heck? Let's do it frontwards.
Going forwards, Sly is still lost.
This is kind of one of those guessing kind of things.
Sly guesses correctly.
Oh my gosh.
But eventually, his luck runs out.
Well, I guess I didn't know where my wheels were.
Not knowing where your wheels are can lead to a head-on collision.
Perhaps when I think that I'm in my lane, maybe I'm not. Maybe I'm half in the other lane, which is kind of a concern.
Speed freak John is afraid to go backwards.
I guess he doesn't trust the fact that we already had it lined up for him.
Not surprisingly, John goes very quickly.
You're doing good. You're on it, I think.
And even though he almost comes off it, having the correct tire pressure keeps him safe. John might look shocked, but he's still as cocky as ever.
I am awesome.
When we come back.
This is not gonna turn out well.
Yes, it is. You'll watch.
The rest of Canada's worst drivers show us if they know where their wheels are.
Who in the right mind does things, tires, water, I don't know.
To see if Canada's worst drivers know where their wheels are...
You're on it, I think.
We're seeing if they can drive across these two rails, going either forwards or backwards.
Whoa.
Daydreamer Ben takes a very backwards approach.
Do you know where your wheels are?
Not a clue.
Ben looks forwards while driving backwards. But he does luckily stay on the rails.
I didn't do anything, I just went backwards.
When driving backwards, you should look backwards.
Oh.
Oops.
Ben. Hit the finish sign.
I have some perception issues.
Animal lover Lori. Quickly decides to go forwards.
Easy, go slow, Lori, go slow.
Lori's going very well. Perhaps she's able to concentrate.
Don't breathe.
Because she doesn't have a carload of animals with her.
Off.
Without distracting animals, Lori seems fine.
Awesomenessity drives here.
Shirley doesn't want to go backwards.
This is not gonna turn out well.
Yes, it is. You'll watch.
Shirley slowly lines up the rails and drives right onto them.
I can't watch because I don't want to fall.
Janice may not have faith, but the tires are supportive.
Are you kidding me?
Shirley makes it off the rail.
I did good.
Shirley's biggest driving problem might just be a lack of confidence.
Janice, I can't believe I've actually done it.
Nervous Tab is up next.
I can't do this.
I can't do it.
I can't do that.
Why not?
Because I don't need to.
Tab does need to know where her wheels are. So.
I'm gonna try.
Okay.
Tab tries the challenge going forwards, which she quickly regrets.
Now I don't know if I can line it up.
Tab lines up, slightly off kilter.
Still let me fall.
Tab is headed for a fall. So, I stop her.
When you think you're fully straight, You're actually a little bit to your right.
With that critical information,
cool.
Tab succeeds.
I got ground. Oh, thank God.
Nervous Tab learned where her wheels are.
I didn't like it one bit, though, I'll tell you that.
Aaron wants to start backwards by looking through the rear window.
No, use the mirrors. Use the mirrors, Aaron.
The mirrors allow Aaron to see that he's moving to the right. So he stops. And he tries to reposition. Oh. Aaron told me that despite his shakiness, he does have the physical tools to be a good driver.
Keep going.
The problem Aaron has as a driver is mental.
Screwed now.
6 years after suffering his brain injury,
I'm gonna fall off.
Aaron still can't make certain driving decisions.
Like, I don't know which way to turn the wheel to correct to get back online.
What we have to do here in rehab is drill information into Aaron so his decisions become automatic.
Oh, fuck.
Aaron is emotionally shaken.
I didn't know how to correct my mistake, and that's what is getting me shaken up, that I didn't know how to correct
it. It's okay.
Afia has been threatening to leave rehab because she says it's
useless.
Cindy, what have I got ourselves into?
Okay, just drive, okay?
I can't see anything, by the way.
I shut up and drive.
Drivers cannot stick their heads out of the vehicle on this challenge. So,
I don't know what they're trying to do here. Just let me see.
Afia slithers to the back of the car. Clearly, she doesn't get the point of this exercise.
Who in the right mind would do something like this?
Okay, watch out, okay?
Who in the right mind does things, rails, tires, water? I don't know.
What Afia was hoping to get out of rehab.
Let's go home. Let's go watch our movie. Bring me home.
When we come back.
It's like a big game of croquet.
Ooh, and I'm the ball.
Canada's worst drivers try to go through the eye of the needle. The Driver Rehabilitation Center, we have experts, specifically driving instructor Peter Mellor, relationship therapist Shamala Kiru, legal expert Cam Woolley, and the man who will teach this season's first and most important lesson, Philippe Letourneau.
Hi, Sly. How are you?
Good.
The number one rule for drivers is always look where you want to go.
Okay.
You see that cone over there?
Yep.
Hit it with the center of the car.
Okay.
When a driver on an open road focuses on a single object, they will hit that object.
What have we learned?
Well, basically, a hit. Right when you're what you're looking at.
Pretty soon, all of Canada's worst drivers learn that they will steer towards what they look at.
Oh, God.
Did you think of the steering at all?
No.
No, huh? So if you get into a skid and there's a post and you don't want to hit the post.
I probably shouldn't look at the post.
Not probably. You shouldn't look at the post, but most people will.
So are you saying
don't look at that wall or that car that you don't want to hit?
Exactly. You got it.
It's called target fixation. You're looking at the problem, you're going to steer towards that problem.
Wow. I didn't think about it like that.
Well, not a lot of people do.
The Look Where You Want to Go course is one we do every year, and we call it the Eye of the Needle. Basically, it's driving a car through 5 archways. And it's not just any car, either. It's the 2009 Dodge Challenger that we made especially pretty for this year's All-Canadian season.
Okay, Eye of the Needle. I gotta go through each arch, and after being the host of this show for many years, I know that to go through each arch, I don't look at the arches, I look at the gap in between. Just like this.
The recommended speed for this course is 60.
60, here we go. Look straight ahead, and there you go, and get in front of each arch before you make it, so you're not turning while you go through the arch. Swish. There you go. Woohoo! Swish. Oh yeah, baby. It's just that easy. Now, let's see how Canada's worst drivers do on the old Eye of the Needle course.
Shirley will go first. Shirley wants to go through the arches at 60 kilometers an hour.
Go. Go.
But she gets going almost 80.
Oh, my God.
Do it. I can't
keep
do it.
Where it is. Yes, she can. Over here. Oh.
Shirley's not looking good headed for the third arch.
Over, over. Look.
Shirley is looking where she wants to go. But her steering is too herky-jerky.
Stop. 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 God.
I'm useless.
I'm nothing but a big disappointment.
Stop.
Shirley learned the lesson, but was unable to apply it.
How long is it going to take me to be able to apply what I'm learning?
Ben also learned the lesson.
I feel like I could probably write a whole essay about this, but now can I apply it? That's the real question.
Ben takes off and looks at his speedometer, then at the arch, then at the speedometer, then at the arch, then in the blink of an eye. Ben hammers the first arch, clips the second, and his speed increases to almost 90.
Too fast.
Ben isn't daydreaming, but he does strike every arch. Ben blames his hits on having to check his speed.
It was a look down, look up thing.
Aaron is up next.
Do you feel comfortable enough?
I never feel comfortable.
When Aaron gets going,
up to speed, up to speed.
He looks great going through the first arch.
Yes.
But his speed is increasing.
Your side, man.
And his steering can't keep up.
Okay.
When Aaron finishes, Lee tries to stay positive.
Not great, but pretty good.
Honestly, that wasn't good at all.
Oh, you did do a number, eh?
Well, yeah, but...
Speed freak John is next.
Need to look where I want to go and not at the target.
John looks where he wants to go, and he goes exactly where he looks. John learned the lesson.
I think you gotta look where you want to go.
Yesterday, John would have focused on the obstacles.
That really look where you want to go helped.
Nervous Tab is up next.
Hands are sweating.
When Tab takes off,
Go, 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 go.
Matt gets her go, go, going over 100. Tab is going so fast.
Oh, missed one.
The third arch is something she can't even turn towards.
It's not big enough.
No. Nervous Tab wasn't slow enough.
I finished off the mirror for you. You're welcome.
When we come back, the rest of Canada's worst drivers see if they can pass through the eye of the needle. Then, they'll reverse a short bus.
How'd you do?
I did bad.
Yeah.
The nominees for Canada's Worst Driver have learned to look where they want to go, instead of looking at obstacles they want to avoid. Lori drives with a live dog around her neck at home.
Animals in their correct position, I assume?
Absolutely, Roger.
The correct position for an animal is in the house if you're driving, not around your neck. Okay, excellent. 60K an hour. Go through every arch.
Don't hit anything.
Lori has hit 20 different objects in her driving career.
Well, slow down a little bit.
But looking where she wants to go is yielding fantastic results. Lori clips one arch. But she's obviously learning.
Awesome, you did good.
Lori looked where she wanted to go.
Without the training, I would have taken the last minute glance at the sides to measure myself and probably would have had the car off kilter and hit it.
Over analytical, Sly is up next. Sly was told to look straight through the arches and put himself in the middle. But Sly took the lesson too literally. His peripheral vision should see the car's corners and the approaching arches. But Sly's pinpointed focus creates tunnel vision.
Touch.
Okay, now stop.
I don't know what was going on because I was looking right at where everything was, where I was supposed to go.
Fred knows what's going on.
My hunch is that Sly was putting himself in the middle of the arches.
What?
Using tunnel vision to focus on a tiny speck in the distance, Sly did indeed put himself right in the middle of the arch, which put Fred right in the middle of harm's way.
Oh, I'm sorry, Fred.
Sly is so literal, it could literally kill him.
You know, it just makes me kind of wonder how in the world I've lasted so long.
Afia has a habit of speeding. And today, on our 60K an hour course, Afia speeds up to 100, then goes faster. And the worst part is, she thinks it's hilarious.
I think I did it. Yeah, but you broke the mirror.
Afia just doesn't get it.
Was it 60?
Mirrors are a critical part of reversing. To see if Canada's worst drivers know how to successfully use their side mirrors while going backwards, their next challenge is to reverse this short bus around this figure eight track. And just to make sure the bad drivers know how good each other is, when they're not driving this bus, they'll be its passengers. John volunteers to go first.
No throwing at the bus driver, you little bastards.
With the folks who nominated Canada's worst drivers watching,
there he goes.
John takes off like a shot.
Oh my gosh.
Rounding the first corner, John doesn't hit anything.
Look at him using those mirrors.
John is the best driver here. He clearly knows what he's doing. Okay, apparently I spoke too soon.
Driving a short bus is actually legal.
Trust your mirrors.
With a normal driver's license, anyone can operate a bus if it has just 8 seats or less.
I'm just gonna take my time now.
Very quickly.
Oh, here we go. He's gonna swing around his front end. Yeah.
John goes faster than he can control again. John has driving skills, but he's driven by bad choices.
You know, I learned something there.
What did you learn?
Go a little bit slower.
John thinks he's better than he really is.
I think I could have did better.
Ben has a full-sized bus driving license.
Technically speaking, this is the truth.
Ben works with autistic adults, and sometimes he has to drive them.
All right, I'll give it a go.
The bus Ben drives them in has more than 8 seats, thus the full-sized license.
I'm about to be fired from my job.
After 2.5 minutes...
I'm sucking.
Ben is still stuck in the first turn.
Oh, this sucks.
Ben's hit count is already up to
14,
15, 16, 17, 18.
Oh my God, I'm horrible.
On the final turn.
Oh my God.
Ben looks very inexperienced.
I've had some experience in the past driving these sorts of things. However, that experience didn't really shine today.
You won't believe this. Tab was a bus driver, too.
What kind of bus did you drive?
It was one of the big orange school buses.
Oh, she drove right. Children to school.
And so why did you give that up?
Pretty much, I found it very stressful for myself.
When Tab gets going, she looks like a total rookie.
I can't believe this. I can't do it anymore.
Huh? Yes, you can.
No, she can't.
I am totally off now. Oh, crap.
Tab is looking at her mirrors. But she isn't understanding what she sees.
Where the hell did the course go?
The one thing...
Crap!
...that you never want to hear a school bus driver say is...
Everybody still alive?
Tab should never have been a school bus driver.
I wasn't driving the kids backwards to school. I was going forward.
When we come back...
Okay, who's guiding me?
The rest of Canada's worst drivers reverse our figure eight.
Straighten it out! Straighten it out!
Oh!
Canada's worst drivers are learning to use their side mirrors by reversing a bus.
Oh my God, I'm horrible.
Afia is up next. Afia isn't checking her mirrors.
Wow, there's some hits you can see coming.
Like that one, for example.
Afia is such a dangerous driver.
No, use your mirrors.
I only use my mirrors to wear makeup.
All the other bad drivers are desperately trying to keep her on course.
Thank you, guys. Left.
Yeah, which your left.
Left, which way?
Here in rehab, we like to be honest. So, when someone drives terribly, we tell them they're driving terribly.
You're doing fine.
It's our belief that telling bad drivers they're fine or great will just confuse them.
You're doing great! Yeah, you got it! Woo-hoo!
Cindy believes that positive reinforcement is what Afia needs for help.
Mentioning the fact that she's a terrible driver won't work. But if you tell her she's a great driver, she's going to believe it and she'll become a better driver.
Calling this great driving would be a vulgar lie.
Why are you looking out the door? Look at your mirrors.
Isn't it finished, though?
No.
I just want to go home.
Afia's driving can only be described as
terrible for someone with a license.
Let them think you're a bad driver. This is not something I care about, to be honest. Some people care. I don't.
Shirley didn't used to use mirrors. In rehab, Shirley is learning to use mirrors. And after this mishap, she seems to get in the groove of actually trusting her mirrors.
Are we sure she's actually driving?
Using her mirrors, Shirley keeps her vehicle in the middle of the lane.
Nicely done, Shirley. Yeah.
All the way to the far turn. Woo! Getting to the finish line.
Beautiful.
Shirley isn't perfect.
Left, 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 left.
Shirley is way better than she was before rehab.
Goosebumps.
When Aaron gets his mirrors adjusted,
down a little, yeah.
He starts off better than anyone.
There he goes. He's doing all right.
Using his mirrors.
Very good.
Aaron looks where he wants to go.
Good, Aaron.
And he goes perfectly.
Nice and easy.
Good.
Left a little bit, Aaron. Left, yeah. Left.
Left.
Or right, sorry. Right.
It can't be easy to concentrate with all this shouting, though.
Straighten it out! Straighten it out!
Off!
Look at him.
Trusting only his mirrors.
Oh, brilliant.
Oh, man.
Aaron has a better drive.
Love you.
Than anyone else in rehab.
Oh, who is this guy? What has he done with my son?
Aaron only hit two things.
I can feel my confidence coming back, and that feels so good.
Sly has already spent 4 minutes on his mirrors.
And how about this one?
He doesn't know where to even aim the mirrors.
The bottom one, what am I supposed to see in the bottom one?
In both mirrors, you should see me.
Full?
Yes.
Okay, then I'm gonna need...
That's what you want, because you want to be able to see back here, right? See, this is how you know what's along the side of your bus.
Okay, well, makes sense.
Hi. Yep. What's that? I think you're good.
That was the longest mirror readjustment in the history of the world.
Go, Sly!
I bet I say go about 8 times before he goes.
Go, Sly! Sly, you should go!
Okay, who's guiding me?
Sly
hard right, hard right.
Is supposed to be guiding himself.
Straight up, straight up, straight up.
But John is directing him so much.
Yeah, keep going, Sly.
Okay.
Sly doesn't even look.
Perfect, keep going, buddy.
Okay.
At his perfectly positioned mirrors.
Straighten up, Sly. Yeah, keep going.
Am I okay?
Even with this constant coaching.
How am I doing?
Sly is now hitting.
Holy cow.
In fact.
Oh, holy cow.
He's hitting so much.
Okay, what am I hitting?
Left.
Ah.
Everyone is now trying to steer him.
Just go straight up, Sly.
Okay, here, I'm starting to get kind of confused here.
Sly never does use his mirrors.
It certainly helped to have some guidance.
Animal lover Lori is the final driver.
Does your real dog get in the way of looking at that mirror?
It does, but Lori won't admit it. Lori focuses in her driver's side mirror and flies through the first turn perfectly.
She's learned all this in the last day and a half. No word of a lie.
Is that right?
Yeah, swear to God. Yeah.
After just 3 minutes,
he has not hit a damn thing.
Lori makes it around the entire figure eight track without hitting anything, thanks to her mirrors.
Are we done? Are you kidding me?
Yeah.
Woo! Woo!
Lori makes a mistake. But she's definitely learning.
I couldn't believe that I had the potential to even do it like that. Woohoo!
When we come back, all the nominees face our experts.
I can't believe I'm crying.
Then, someone is named this year's first graduate.
So the graduate is...
When Canada's worst drivers arrived in rehab, I confiscated their driver's licenses.
Yeah.
There you go.
The hair looks good.
You think you'll get that back?
Well, I kind of hope so, yeah.
You'll get that back if you graduate.
The experts and I will decide who that first graduate will be. Once we speak with everyone, starting with Ben.
I thought that I, you know, would be one of the first to graduate. No longer. I no longer believe that my confidence has dwindled down to probably where it should be.
Shirley doesn't want to graduate. She wants to keep learning things like...
Keep my eye focused on where I want the vehicle to go. And as simple as that sounds... I wasn't doing that.
Nervous Tab won't graduate yet either. But Philippe thinks he knows the cause of her anxiety.
You're not looking far enough. You don't have time to gather enough information.
I would say I look ahead.
That's where you want to be looking, as far away.
I got a hard time believing that.
What?
It's proven that we look plus or minus 35 feet in front of us. That's the way we are designed. And that's one of the reasons I believe you're stressed out, because you don't have time to analyze what's going on.
I would agree with that, actually, now that you've pointed it out.
Afia is desperate to learn more.
What's your motivation, Afia? Why do you want to learn?
I just want to go home. So if I have to learn to go home, I'll learn.
Sly is learning, but he needs more practice.
Practice makes perfect.
How often do you usually have to do something before it becomes understood to you?
Thousands and thousands of times, maybe sometimes. I don't know.
Lori was almost perfect in every challenge this episode.
I believe I deserve to be the first to graduate. But I do believe that there's many other skills that I could gain and learn.
For starters, Lori needs to learn that at home, she's putting her pets' lives in jeopardy.
Where's Labrador ride usually?
In the passenger seat.
Turn off the airbag then.
because that's gonna kill him. If there's a collision, if somebody else hits your truck, the airbag's gonna deploy. It's gonna seriously injure or kill the guy, because he's gonna go right into it. You know, you can get a seatbelt for the dog.
Can you?
Yeah, they're seatbelts and they're safe.
I never thought of it that way, of the animals getting hurt.
What will you do differently?
I'm not going to travel the same way I do with my animals in the vehicle.
John wants to graduate because he claims that Aaron has changed him.
You know what it was with him, man? He clicked something up there. I think you might be the guy that changes my driving habits. Yeah.
How so?
I really think so, buddy. I think hearing your story and stuff really made me slow down. I think it's gonna be good.
Cool. Then you just made it all worth it.
Are you telling me with a straight face that after a couple of conversations with Aaron, you're not going to speed in public anymore?
Whenever I go out and drive, I'm definitely not gonna do what I do now. I don't want to be that guy that does that to someone, right?
John promises to slow down. And more importantly,
I will never text and drive again.
Aaron is certainly grateful that John has promised to stop driving distracted.
I have been asking to hear that for 5 years.
Well, this is what it's all about. Time to give the first graduate back their license.
John and Lori are the only two people who could conceivably graduate this week.
I think John should graduate. He really had an epiphany dealing with Aaron. He made a promise on the distracted driving. I think it was credible there.
You know what? I don't usually agree with you, but this time I would agree. He made a big change by meeting Aaron, and I think it will change him forever.
I want to believe John, but I don't. I just don't believe him.
Shamala thinks Lori should graduate because of her promise to stop driving with loose animals.
I got the sense that with Lori, she's really going to make the changes.
I also think Lori should graduate before John.
Lori literally drove better than him. Eye of the needle, Lori aced it. Reversing, way better than John.
Two want Lori to graduate, two want John. It's up to Peter to break the tie. And break the tie, Peter does.
Which means it's time for the first one of our bad drivers to graduate and once again hit those public roads. So, who will be this year's first graduate? Well, there was just two of you on the short list. John, you. And Lori, you. Lori, you drove every challenge, quite frankly, better than anybody else here. And John, you, in the studio, promised that you would slow down and that you would never text and drive again. So, who's it gonna be? Lori? You said you wanted to stick around so you could learn more. So the graduate is John.
Before coming to rehab, John was dangerously cocky.
Yeah, his best driver.
Thanks to Aaron, though, John has been humble.
I made a promise to the panel that I would stop texting while driving, and stop use my phone while driving, and speeding while driving.
Given John's history as a driver, you might doubt the sincerity of his promise.
You don't know what's coming up over this.
What I would say to those people that think I'm doing this all for camera is that, off, it's not.
That's it, guys.
Way to go, buddy. Congratulations.
Enjoy life, guys.
Join us next episode when we teach more life-saving skills
to Canada's worst drivers.
On the next episode of Canada's Worst Driver.
Oh, I'm getting it.
Your front wheels haven't even crossed the starting line yet.
They haven't?
No.
We test the nominees' reaction times. Oh. We teach them how to do a proper shoulder check. And then...
I'm trying to open my cookies.
Everyone drives distracted.
This, while driving, is stupid. Eight very scary people have been taken off the street and brought to our rehabilitation center. And when I say eight very scary people, what I mean is...
One of the eight people behind me really is... Canada's worst driver.
Tab, and I've been nominated as Canada's Worst Driver by my boyfriend, Matt.
In downtown Calgary, Tab might be the most nervous person on the road.
See, I don't know.
My name is Afia, and I've been nominated by my friend Cindy as Canada's Worst Driver.
In Montreal, Afia might be the most careless driver on the road.
Oh my God.
My name is Ben, and I was nominated by my wife Jan as Canada's Worst Driver.
In Surrey, BC, Ben might be the biggest daydreamer on the road.
Everybody's wondering who that guy is. It's this guy.
My name is John. I've been nominated by my girlfriend Elise as Canada's Worst Driver.
In Bowmanville, Ontario.
I know it's gonna sound dumb.
Corvette owner John delusionally believes the key to safe texting and driving
is check up like every 3 seconds. You're good.
My name is Sly, and I've been nominated by my brother-in-law Fred as Canada's Worst Driver.
In Lethbridge, Alberta, delivery man Sly...
Order's been picked up.
...got 3 tickets this month for speeding...
In a 30 zone.
In a 30 zone.
In a 30 zone.
So that sounds like a school zone?
Yeah.
My name is Lori, and I've been nominated by Sean, my boyfriend, as Canada's Worst Driver.
In Prince Albert, Saskatchewan, Lori likes to drive with a loose bird, a loose cat... and 2 unrestrained dogs.
I couldn't even tell you how many objects I've hit.
My name is Shirley, and I've been nominated by my daughter Janice as Canada's Worst Driver.
On the highways of Nova Scotia...
Why are you slowing down?
Shirley has a tendency to stop.
Don't stop, you don't stop, you don't stop.
My name is Aaron, and I've been nominated by my father, Lee, as Canada's Worst Driver.
Aaron was a good driver 6 years ago, but a distracted driver T-boned Aaron. After 2 months in a coma and 6 years of recovery, Aaron is driving around Calgary again, although very badly.
Is that your turn?
Oh.
as a driver, if you don't know where your wheels are, you could wind up anywhere. So the next challenge for Canada's worst drivers is to show us they know where their wheels are by maneuvering a car across those two rails. But first, they have to decide if they want to go backwards, which frankly is kind of scary, or if they want to go forwards, which, let's face it, is a lot easier than going backwards. To encourage them to go backwards, the rear wheels are already on the rails. Well, the car's lined up to go backwards, so I'm gonna go backwards. Reversing on this course is easy because...
Mirrors? Mirrors?
The mirrors show me the rear wheels and the rails.
And that's perfect.
Will Canada's worst drivers take advantage of our perfect setup? Analytical Sly makes the right decision. But he's going backwards.
Man, I can't believe I'm doing this.
Without using his mirrors. Sly hasn't failed yet. Drivers will only fail this challenge if they manage to get stuck permanently.
Yeah, you're gonna try it backwards again, or you're gonna line up frontwards this time?
Oh, what the heck? Let's do it frontwards.
Going forwards, Sly is still lost.
This is kind of one of those guessing kind of things.
Sly guesses correctly.
Oh my gosh.
But eventually, his luck runs out.
Well, I guess I didn't know where my wheels were.
Not knowing where your wheels are can lead to a head-on collision.
Perhaps when I think that I'm in my lane, maybe I'm not. Maybe I'm half in the other lane, which is kind of a concern.
Speed freak John is afraid to go backwards.
I guess he doesn't trust the fact that we already had it lined up for him.
Not surprisingly, John goes very quickly.
You're doing good. You're on it, I think.
And even though he almost comes off it, having the correct tire pressure keeps him safe. John might look shocked, but he's still as cocky as ever.
I am awesome.
When we come back.
This is not gonna turn out well.
Yes, it is. You'll watch.
The rest of Canada's worst drivers show us if they know where their wheels are.
Who in the right mind does things, rails, tires, water? I don't know.
To see if Canada's worst drivers know where their wheels are...
You're on it, I think.
We're seeing if they can drive across these two rails, going either forwards or backwards.
Whoa.
Daydreamer Ben takes a very backwards approach.
Do you know where your wheels are?
Not a clue.
Ben looks forwards while driving backwards. But he does luckily stay on the rails.
I didn't do anything, I just went backwards.
When driving backwards, you should look backwards.
Oh.
Oops.
Ben. Hit the finish sign.
I have some perception issues.
Animal lover Lori. Quickly decides to go forwards.
Easy, go slow, Lori, go slow.
Lori's going very well. Perhaps she's able to concentrate.
Don't breathe.
Because she doesn't have a carload of animals with her.
Off.
Without distracting animals, Lori seems fine.
Awesomenessity drives here.
Shirley doesn't want to go backwards.
This is not gonna turn out well.
Yes, it is. You'll watch.
Shirley slowly lines up the rails and drives right onto them.
I can't watch because I don't want to fall.
Janice may not have faith, but the tires are supportive.
Are you kidding me?
Shirley makes it off the rail.
I did good.
Shirley's biggest driving problem might just be a lack of confidence.
Janice, I can't believe I've actually done it.
Nervous Tab is up next.
I can't do this.
I can't do it.
I can't do that.
Why not?
Because I don't need to.
Tab does need to know where her wheels are, so
I'm gonna try.
Okay.
Tab tries the challenge going forwards, which she quickly regrets.
Now I don't know if I can line it up.
Tab lines up, slightly off kilter.
Just don't let me fall.
Tab is headed for a fall, so I stop her.
When you think you're fully straight, you're actually a little bit to your right.
With that critical information,
go, go, go.
Tab succeeds.
I got ground. Oh, thank God.
Nervous Tab learned where her wheels are.
I didn't like it one bit, though, I'll tell you that.
Aaron wants to start backwards by looking through the rear window.
No, use the mirrors. Use the mirrors, Aaron.
The mirrors allow Aaron to see that he's moving to the right, so he stops. And he tries to reposition. Oh. Aaron told me that despite his shakiness, he does have the physical tools to be a good driver.
Keep going, keep going. Keep going.
The problem Aaron has as a driver is mental.
Screwed now.
6 years after suffering his brain injury,
I'm gonna fall off.
Aaron still can't make certain driving decisions.
Like, I don't know which way to turn the wheel to correct to get back online.
What we have to do here in rehab is drill information into Aaron so his decisions become automatic.
Oh, fuck.
Aaron is emotionally shaken.
I didn't know how to correct my mistake, and that's what is getting me shaken up, that I didn't know how to correct.
It's okay, it's okay.
Afia has been threatening to leave rehab because she says it's
useless. Cindy, what have I got ourselves into?
Okay, just drive, okay?
I can't see anything, by the way.
I shut up and drive.
Drivers cannot stick their heads out of the vehicle on this challenge, so
I don't know what they're trying to do here. Just let me see.
Afia slithers to the back of the car. Clearly, she doesn't get the point of this exercise.
Who in the right mind would do something like this?
Okay, watch out, okay?
Who in the right mind does things, rails, tires, water? I don't know.
I don't know what Afia was hoping to get out of rehab.
Let's go home. Let's go watch our movie. Bring me home.
When we come back.
It's like a big game of croquet.
Ooh, and I'm the ball.
Canada's worst drivers try to go through the eye of the needle.
Oh.
The Driver Rehabilitation Center, we have experts, specifically driving instructor Peter Mellor, relationship therapist, eight very scary people have been taken off the street and brought to our rehabilitation center. when I say 8 very scary people? What I mean is...
one of the 8 people behind me really is Canada's worst driver.
Tab, and I've been nominated as Canada's worst driver by my boyfriend, Matt.
In downtown Calgary, Tab might be the most nervous person on the road.
See, I don't know. I need a call.
My name is Afia, and I've been nominated by my friend Cindy as Canada's worst driver.
In Montreal, Afia might be the most careless driver on the road.
Oh my God.
My name is Ben, and I was nominated by my wife Jan as Canada's worst driver.
In Surrey, BC, Ben might be the biggest daydreamer on the road.
Everybody's wondering who that guy is. It's this guy.
My name is John. I've been nominated by my girlfriend Elise as Canada's worst driver.
In Bowmanville, Ontario.
I know it's gonna sound dumb.
Corvette owner John delusionally believes the key to safe texting and driving
is check up like every 3 seconds. You're good.
My name is Sly, and I've been nominated by my brother-in-law Fred as Canada's worst driver.
In Lethbridge, Alberta, delivery man Sly,
order's been picked up,
got 3 tickets this month for speeding
in a 30 zone,
in a 30 zone,
in a 30 zone.
So it sounds like a school zone.
Yeah.
My name is Lori, and I've been nominated by Sean, my boyfriend, as Canada's worst driver.
In Prince Albert, Saskatchewan, Lori likes to drive with a loose bird, a loose cat, and 2 unrestrained dogs.
I couldn't even tell you how many objects I've hit.
My name is Shirley, and I've been nominated by my daughter Janice as Canada's worst driver.
On the highways of Nova Scotia,
why are you slowing down?
Shirley has a tendency to stop.
Don't stop, you don't stop, you don't stop.
My name is Aaron, and I've been nominated by my father, Lee, as Canada's worst driver.
Aaron was a good driver 6 years ago, but a distracted driver T-boned Aaron. After 2 months in a coma and 6 years of recovery, Aaron is driving around Calgary again, although very badly.
Is that your turn?
Oh.
As a driver, if you don't know where your wheels are, you could wind up anywhere. So the next challenge for Canada's worst drivers is to show us they know where their wheels are by maneuvering your car across those 2 rails. But first, they have to decide if they want to go backwards, which frankly is kind of scary, or if they want to go forwards, which, let's face it, is a lot easier than going backwards.
To encourage them to go backwards, the rear wheels are already on the rails.
Well, the car's lined up to go backwards, so,
I'm gonna go backwards. Reversing on this course is easy, because...
mirrors? Mirrors?
The mirrors show me the rear wheels and the rails.
And that's perfect.
Will Canada's worst drivers take advantage of our perfect setup? Analytical Sly makes the right decision. but he's going backwards.
Man, I can't believe I'm doing this.
Without using his mirrors. Sly hasn't failed yet. Drivers will only fail this challenge if they manage to get stuck permanently.
Yeah, you're gonna try it backwards again, or you're gonna line up frontwards this time?
Oh, what the heck? Let's do it frontwards.
Going forwards, Sly is still lost.
This is kind of one of those guessing kind of things.
Sly guesses correctly.
Oh my gosh.
But eventually, his luck runs out.
Well, I guess I didn't know where my wheels were.
Not knowing where your wheels are can lead to a head-on collision.
Perhaps when I think that I'm in my lane, maybe I'm not. Maybe I'm half in the other lane, which is kind of a concern.
Speed freak John is afraid to go backwards.
I guess he doesn't trust the fact that we already had it lined up for him.
Not surprisingly, John goes very quickly.
You're doing good. You're on it, I think.
And even though he almost comes off it, having the correct tire pressure keeps him safe. John might look shocked, but he's still as cocky as ever.
I am awesome.
When we come back.
This is not going to turn out well.
Yes, it is. You'll watch.
The rest of Canada's worst drivers show us
If
they know where their wheels are.
Who in the right mind does things, rails, tires, water, I don't know.
To see if Canada's worst drivers know where their wheels are.
You're on it, I think.
We're seeing if they can drive across these two rails. Going either forwards or backwards.
Whoa.
Daydreamer Ben takes a very backwards approach.
Do you know where your wheels are?
Not a clue.
Ben looks forwards while driving backwards. But he does luckily stay on the rails.
I didn't do anything, I just went backwards.
When driving backwards, you should look backwards.
Oh.
Oops.
Ben hit the finish sign.
I have some perception issues.
Animal lover Lori quickly decides to go forwards.
Easy, go slow, Lori, go slow.
Lori's going very well. Perhaps she's able to concentrate.
Don't breathe.
Because she doesn't have a carload of animals with her.
Off.
Without distracting animals, Lori seems fine.
Awesomenessity drives here.
Shirley doesn't want to go backwards.
This is not gonna turn out well.
Yes, it is. You'll watch.
Shirley slowly lines up the rails and drives right onto them.
I can't watch because I don't want to fall.
Janice may not have faith, but the tires are supportive.
Are you kidding me?
Shirley makes it off the rail.
I did good.
Shirley's biggest driving problem might just be a lack of confidence.
Janice, I can't believe I've actually done it.
Nervous Tab is up next.
I can't do this.
I can't do it.
I can't do that.
Why not?
Because I don't need to.
Tab does need to know where her wheels are. So
I'm gonna try.
Okay.
Tab tries the challenge going forwards, which she quickly regrets.
Now I don't know if I can line it up.
Tab lines up, slightly off kilter.
Just don't let me fall.
Tab is headed for a fall. So I stop her.
When you think you're fully straight, you're actually a little bit to your right.
With that critical information,
cool.
Tab succeeds.
I got ground. Oh, thank God.
nervous tab, learned where her wheels are.
I didn't like it one bit, though, I'll tell you that.
Aaron wants to start backwards by looking through the rear window.
No, use the mirrors. Use the mirrors, Aaron.
The mirrors allow Aaron to see that he's moving to the right. So he stops. And he tries to reposition. Aaron told me that despite his shakiness, he does have the physical tools to be a good driver.
Keep going, keep going. Keep going.
The problem Aaron has as a driver is mental.
Screwed now.
6 years after suffering his brain injury,
I'm gonna fall off.
Aaron still can't make certain driving decisions.
Like, I don't know which way to turn the wheel to correct to get back online.
What we have to do here in rehab is drill information into Aaron so his decisions become automatic.
Oh, fuck.
Aaron is emotionally shaken.
I didn't know how to correct my mistake, and that's what is getting me shaken up, that I didn't know how to correct
it. It's okay.
Afia has been threatening to leave rehab because she says it's
useless. Cindy, what have I got ourselves into?
Okay, just drive, okay?
I can't see anything, by the way.
I shut up and drive.
Drivers cannot stick their heads out of the vehicle on this challenge. So,
I don't know what they're trying to do here. Just let me see.
Afia slithers to the back of the car. Clearly, she doesn't get the point of this exercise.
Who in the right mind would do something like this?
Okay, watch out, okay?
Who in the right mind does things, rails, tires, water? I don't know.
I don't know what Afia was hoping to get out of rehab.
Let's go home. Let's go watch our movie. Bring me home.
When we come back.
It's like a big game of croquet.
Oh, and I'm the ball.
Canada's worst drivers try to go through the eye of the needle. The Driver Rehabilitation Center, we have experts, specifically driving instructor Peter Mellor, relationship therapist Shamala Kiru, legal expert Cam Woolley, and the man who will teach this season's first and most important lesson, Philippe Letourneau.
Hi, Sly.
Hi.
How are you?
Good.
The number one rule for drivers is always look where you want to go.
Okay.
You see that cone over there?
Yep.
Hit it with the center of the car.
Okay.
When a driver on an open road focuses on a single object, they will hit that object.
What have we learned?
Well, basically, you hit right when you're what you're looking at.
Pretty soon, all of Canada's worst drivers learn that they will steer towards what they look at.
Oh, God.
Did you think of the steering at all?
No.
No, huh? So if you get into a skid and there's a post and you don't want to hit the post.
I probably shouldn't look at the post.
Not probably. You shouldn't look at the post, but most people will.
So, are you saying don't look at that wall or that car that you don't want to hit?
Exactly. You got it. It's called target fixation. You're looking at the problem, you're going to steer towards that problem.
Wow. I didn't think about it like that.
Well, not a lot of people do.
The Look Where You Want to Go course is one we do every year, and we call it the Eye of the Needle. Basically, it's driving a car through 5 archways. And it's not just any car, either. It's the 2009 Dodge Challenger that we made especially pretty for this year's All-Canadian season.
Okay, Eye of the Needle. I gotta go through each arch, and after being the host of this show for many years, I know that to go through each arch, I don't look at the arches, I look at the gap in between. Just like this.
The recommended speed for this course is 60.
60, here we go. Look straight ahead, and there you go, and get in front of each arch before you make it, so you're not turning while you go through the arch. Swish. There you go. Woo-hoo-hoo. Swish. Oh yeah, baby. It's just that easy. Now, let's see how Canada's worst drivers do on the old Eye of the Needle course.
Shirley will go first. Shirley wants to go through the arches at 60 kilometers an hour.
Go. Go.
But she gets going almost 80.
Oh, my God.
Do it. I can't
keep
do it.
Where it is. Yes, she can. Over here. Oh.
Shirley's not looking good headed for the third arch.
Over, over. Look.
Shirley is looking where she wants to go. But her steering is too herky-jerky.
Stop. 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 God.
I'm useless. I'm nothing but a big disappointment.
Stop.
Shirley learned the lesson, but was unable to apply it.
How long is it going to take me to be able to apply what I'm learning?
Ben also learned the lesson.
I feel like I could probably write a whole essay about this, but now can I apply it? That's the real question.
Ben takes off and looks at his speedometer, then at the arch, then at the speedometer, then at the arch.